Greetings, Laddingtons. Today I want to respond to a somewhat commonly asked question, and that is why I sometimes refer to myself as an elf. And before I begin to elaborate, I would like to aim a massive heartfelt thank you to Styx Hexenhammer 666, who gave me a shout-out in a recent video. So thank you for that, Styx, and also this speaks very highly of you, because that is a clear sign of confidence when you can give attention and shoutouts to other people. So tipspickelhabe at styxhexenhammer666. Thank you, much appreciated. So on to the elven question at hand. There is actually quite a few different perspectives or points I would like to bring up here. So it's not only that I think Lord of the Rings and Warhammer is great. Obviously I'm a big fan of both, and I'm a big fan of fantasy, but the elven question goes a bit deeper than that. So we can take the aesthetic point. I kind of look like an elf, just how it is. Same thing with the physique. I do have a somewhat elven physique, a bit jacked elf, but still, you know, with a smaller waist and a bit tall and everything like that. So an elven appearance, obviously with hair as well. Secondly, elvendom, and referring to myself as an elf, is a response to boomer masculinity. And what boomer masculinity is the kind of guys who says, oh, real men eat meat, or real men do not care about how they look, or real men do this and that. Now, if we look upon Lord of the Rings, who has the highest kill count in the entire fellowship? Yeah, it is Legolas. And then you still have guys who say, oh, he's so gay and everything like that because of whatever reasons, because he doesn't have a beard or because this and that. So that is a response. Obviously, a high capacity for violence in accord with the primordial truth is a good sign as a man. So if someone says a real man eats meat, then I say no, that's absolutely not the case. A real man is determined by his actions and his capacity for violence, strength, enlightenment, how reliable he is. All of these things are Legolas, yeah, he checks off all of these points. So elves are very masculine in that regard. They don't look masculine because they look perhaps a bit feminine, but it's the capacity that matters. So if you look upon a shield brother you have, you obviously want someone who, when it's time to step up, he can perform. So if we talk about an elf as a human archetype, because this is what this is about, it's not about fantasy necessarily, it's also about the elven archetype among humans. So what would you prefer? Some guy who goes around thinking that he is so hench all the time, thinking he's the coolest ever? Or would you rather have a calm, disciplined guy who doesn't go around being all, you know, brash like that, but he keeps his composure, and you know that when it's go time, you know that he can, you know, show up, step up when it matters. So that is also something I view with the elven archetype, that it's not about going around being all hench all the time, but it's about when it time comes, then you have the capacity for violence. So a bit like a martial artist, like a true martial artist, I suppose. So that is the response to the boomer masculinity point, that men are determined by what they eat or what they look like. A man is supposed to be determined upon his qualities. So the next question, viewing elves as an human archetype in behavior. You can't really imagine Legolas or any other elf going down the street being obnoxious or being disrespectful towards others. An elf is an Übermensch, it's an overman who is disciplined and orderly and is as far from a subhuman as is possible. So a subhuman is someone who is very impulsive, who can't control his primal instincts, who you know, acts upon emotions, whereas the opposite of a subhuman, an Übermensch, an overman, is someone who keeps himself under control. Even if he has an impulse, he overrides that. His mind is in complete control of his body. So two completely different things. So you can view an orc on one side, an elf on the other side. The elf has superb discipline. He does never act out of order, he never lets his emotions get the best of him, even though he can be emotional. He never lets emotions get him into bad situations, whereas an orc maybe impulsive, never thinks about the consequences, etc. So an elf in the archetype of a human is someone who is disciplined in that regard. Then, next point, if you look upon an elven society, it's obviously close to nature, disciplined, orderly, they value beauty and structure, hierarchy, all of these things, and an elven individual values usually, in basically all literature as well, they value enlightenment, they value martial prowess, they value art and the finer things. So if you look upon European culture, for example, are you an archetype elf who appreciates the higher culture of Europe, or are you an orc who appreciates perhaps drama shows on the TV? The elven archetype obviously appreciates the more beautiful and cultured things. So yeah, those were just some points in regards to why I, when I talk about elves, etc., I primarily mean it as an human archetype of something higher. So if you're talking about elven society, it's a goal that we can strive towards, something that is a bit more in tune with nature, who values order, hierarchy, enlightenment, beauty, and everything like that. So, I hope this was somewhat informative at least, and gave you some new perspectives. Looking quite juicy as well today. XOXO, boom!